Firstly, welcome to the 19 World Influencers. We're going to be talking on the impact of the COVID-19 in the Indian economy and the steps which need to be taken. So, ladies and gentlemen, first up for our World Influencer, we have none other than Mr. R. Kannan, who is the Head Corporate Performance Monitoring of the Hinduja Group. So, Mr. Kannan, firstly, welcome to the 19 Influencers talk on the COVID-19 impact. It's an absolute pleasure and honor to have you today. For the first question, Mr. Kannan, I would like to ask is that how do you think the COVID-19 crisis is affecting the Indian economy as a whole?
So I'm very happy to be here as a part of the program, where almost most of the economic activities have come to a kind of a standstill now. And we find that most of the factories in India, they are almost closed. Some of these companies which are supplying essential goods,
yes, sir,
they are operating today. But whenever we talk about this crisis has affected every segment of the society.
Sure. So, Mr. Kannan, coming from a very huge background as you come in terms of 30 plus years, now what do you feel are the steps and measures which are being taken to minimize the impact, the COVID-19 impact on the economy currently?
In a situation like this, governments have to focus on four types of policies. One is the health policy. That is the most important policy the governments have to take care. So governments are very, very fast in coming out with a lot of measures on how to prevent the spread of this disease.
Sure.
Second is this fiscal policy, where the governments across the world came up with a lot of stimulus measures to keep the economic activity going.
Yes.
Third is the monetary policy by central banks. What they have done is that they have injected a lot of liquidity into the system. And fourth is the financing requirements for various segments of the society.
Sure.
The Indian government was very, very fast, and they went and announced a stimulus measure for 1.7 lakh crores in the first phase, which will meet the needs of various segments of the society.
Absolutely.
The RBI announced also a lot of measures whereby they announced a 1 lakh crore injection into the economy. In addition to that, ever since the onset of this crisis, RBI has brought 1.4 lakh crores of new notes into the system.
Okay.
So what this has done is that one of the important things in a crisis like this is liquidity.
Absolutely.
Because cash should be available in the hands of people, it should be available in the hands of the corporates, it should be available wherever it is required to meet the health emergencies.
Great answer there, Mr. Kannan. A lot of information for all our viewers right there. Now, coming from a strong financial background, which you carry, sir, would there be, Mr. Kannan, anything you would like to suggest to the finance leaders across the world, or the business owners, or a layman probably, or, you know, on finance restructuring? How do you think the finance restructuring should be happening at this stage?
There is something called modern monetary theory, by which the central bank prints notes, government borrows money, then they go on use this money across the sectors so that the economy continues to grow. So this is a great restructuring in terms of the economy, how the economy functions.
Yes.
And coming to corporates, in a situation like this, one of the major issues of any corporate is liquidity. So the immediate priority for any finance leader in the industry is to make sure that all the time the company has got enough cash to run the operations.
Yes.
This is a cash flow. Apart from this, in terms of restructuring in the medium and long term, what happens is that all these years the companies are able to borrow cheap. Well, across the world, more than $15 trillion of funds,
yes,
are carrying a negative interest. So
yes,
all those funds which were carrying negative interest, they came to India.
Hmm.
So India, we are giving interest of 7-8%, which was very cheap for corporates. So corporates went and borrowed money because they were available cheap. So most of the companies went and grew on a leveraged strategy.
Yes.
But in a crisis situation like this, the company is leveraged. If a debt is much higher than equity, then the company's financial position is very good. So what companies have to do is that they have to go and reduce the debt as much as possible. And third thing is that the companies have to restructure their cost in terms of more biased towards variable expenses, less biased towards fixed expenses. You have to convert most of cost into variable cost. The next one is that there is a situation like this, you have to make a budget where I can make a sale of 80,000, I can make a sale of 90,000, I can make a sale of 100,000. So you have to have three scenarios and say under these three scenarios, what should be my budget? So it's called scenario planning and flexible budgeting. You have to give a lot of focus on risk management and governance systems and reporting systems.
Mr. Kannan, for the final question, now you've had a lot of televised appearances across major channels in not only India but across the world. Now your opinion is very strong on the Indian economy and you've had an immense knowledge on the same. So we just, you know, the viewers would like to know that how would the Indian economy as of now reboot on a whole currently?
Capacity of private sector to manage this crisis is very, very limited.
Limited.
We want the growth to come from private sector. So at present, the role of government to kickstart the economic growth is very, very important. And government has to play a very big role.
Yes.
And if you go into any economy, I think we should not look at too much into what is the fiscal deficit. So the government should at least look at an additional borrowing of another 14 lakh crores. Most of the money will come from RBI. Government can create a new vehicle for sovereign crisis fund. So sure. In that vehicle, they can issue what is called corona bonds.
Corona bonds.
So they can carry an interest rate of 4%. The subscribers to this bond will be RBI. Who can subscribe to these bonds? RBI by printing new money. SBI has got a lot of cash surplus. LIC has got a lot of cash surplus. A lot of public sector banks are having. And plus, what happens is that a lot of foreign investors, when it is a sovereign fund, foreign investors will come and invest in the fund. What the government has to do, they have to take this fund and go and invest in not only public sector banks as an equity, but also private sector banks. So 1 rupee invested in a bank, the bank can leverage the balance sheet by 9 times.
Okay.
Suppose a government invests 20,000 crores in a bank, which means the bank can borrow another 180,000 crores. So actually, they can lend about 150,000 crores. So, you know, NBFC, a lot of NBFCs in India are double B rated. So government can also buy these bonds, creating liquidity in the system. All these are going to help India, and we will end up this year with a positive growth. But in the first quarter and second quarter, we are likely to see a negative growth. So the next 2 quarters, by giving the stimulus, we can certainly hope for a positive growth in the Indian economy.
So Mr. Kannan, on the note that the third and the fourth quarter could look at having a positive economic growth, that's a really good sign. And I'm sure the viewers would be elated to hear that. So once again, a big, big thank you, Mr. Kannan, for joining in the first very incredible episode of the 19 Influencers talking on the COVID-19. It's always great to chat up with you. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Bhavana, for the pleasure being with you today and share some of my views.
Sure.
Thank you once again.
Thank you.